Well, a warm welcome one and all on what has been an horrendous, a wet, wet evening. Thankfully, this rain has been deemed to be within reasonable limits, and after an inspection and all the regular formalities, the teams were handed in on time, and the all-important go-ahead was given. Bit of disruption, of course, for those travelling in the direction of the ground. The crowds have taken a little longer than usual to get in and to settle down, but thankfully, that is behind us, and we are on track. Well, it is a great view inside Wembley. It gives it that special feeling no matter which match it is hosting. And we rise now for the English national anthem. They have thrown down the gauntlet with that anthem. Now to match it. Which player is best equipped for this game?
Yeah, David Alaba, one of the most versatile players out there. He's just got so much positional awareness and intelligence. He can basically do a job anywhere on this pitch. He's got fabulous technique too, especially with his delivery in and around the area. He'll be eyeing up any set plays the opposition concede in that defensive third.
Yeah, I must agree, especially in view of his ability to lead and organise the defence. And that gets things running. Down Bartlinger. Dragovic. Hinteregger. Jordan Henderson. Chilwell, Sterling, Jordan Henderson, Chilwell, Jordan Henderson, and it's Sterling, Oxlade-Chamberlain, Alexander-Arnold, a really good feat from him. Oxlade-Chamberlain tries to stroke it through. I think a cautious start from both teams. Hinteregger, and it's played forward. And here's Arnautovic. Out to the left it goes. Managed to get it away. Stones is there, and he can get that clear.
England have pushed both fullbacks into quite advanced positions here.
Yeah, that's interesting. So what are they attempting to do?
Well, it's a bold attempt, in my opinion, to occupy the opposition in a way they're not expecting.
And it's Chilwell. Into the middle. Defending of the desperate variety. Alaba. Dragovic tries to get it forward quickly. Baumgartlinger. Eastrun and Arnautovic! Oh, the keeper's done ever so well.
Arnautovic sparked a tremendous stop there, and I think it's fair to add, he just wasn't expecting it.
And that's been levered clear. Alaba. The ball has crossed the line, and it's a throw. Oh, some tackle that. Bit of an appeal, but nothing doing. No complaints about that challenge. Robust, but fair. Chilwell drives it forward. Kane plays it out to the wing. And here's Sterling. Jordan Henderson. Get the better of his opposite number.
Sancho really was well marshalled there because he was denied the opportunity to turn.
Heading towards half time and it is still scoreless. Alaba plays it over to the other flank. Baumgartlinger. Over to the left. Aimed in towards the centre. He's there to get rid. That is terrific skill. Over to the left. And it's Alaba. Alaba crosses into the box. It's a goal kick. Alexander-Arnold hoists it forward. In with the challenge. Half-time whistle goes, so both sides have drawn blanks and have toiled at times, but it's not been a bad game by any means. So your views on the first half?
Yeah, the scoreline doesn't tell the whole story, as one side has been significantly better, at least defensively.
No goals at this stage, but certainly not devoid of action. It is 0-0 here at half-time. And we're already back underway here.
Austria clearly have been the better side for me. Yeah, I know the score doesn't quite reflect it, but if they go about their game in the same manner as the opening 45 minutes, things really should improve.
Did really well to intervene and dispel the growing danger. Kane. Now it's Sterling. And back to base. Dragovic. Good challenge, he just stood firm. Henderson goes looking.
Well, I don't think it was the wisest option, Peter. Once he got into that position, it's not as if he didn't have people nearby.
Baumgartlinger. Hinteregger. Forward it goes. Lays it out to the flank. Danger averted for now. Sancho. Sancho proving impossible to wrestle off the ball. Rice. And here's Kane. Oh, shooting chance! It's a bit of penetration to go with all this possession. Dragovic.
Well, for me, Peter, it's kind of possession without penetration now. They have to change tack, they really do.
Very few chances to talk of, Jim. Defence is, it seems, on top here.
Well, I think it's a fair reflection on what we've seen so far. Neither side has produced that many efforts at goal simply because respective defences have been strong.
Sancho. He's has a hit! Big relief, it just needed better contact.
England know they can rely on the counter and they've just expressed a warning.
Baumgartlinger. Played out to the right. Hoists it high. Pass needed to be better than that, and he knows it. Could cross it here. Gets up to head it! Header, but really it was all about the delivery.
Yeah, I just thought he wanted that more than anyone else on the pitch, and it was fully deserved. He gave it everything he had.
Austria take the lead, 1-0.
Well, we certainly had to wait for it, Peter. Now a difficult decision. Is it stick or twist?
Henderson plays it forward. Oh, sweet feet. And it's Henderson. Lovely feet. Out to the left it goes. Hit into the middle.
Peter, they have to fight the onset of desperation and keep enough cool heads to still deliver.
Yeah, it's pretty obvious as to who was going to be taken off. His energy levels began to sag, and he was never going to last until the final whistle. Hardly anything between the sides. And the score is 1-0. Out to the right. Oh, the less said about that pass, the better. Maguire. Rice plays it out to the flank. And here's Rashford. Pumps it into the area. Being repelled.
England are definitely not going down without a scrap. Their attitude just can't be faulted.
Hinteregger. Into the last 5 minutes. It is just a question of running down the clock now. Alaba. Rice. Rashford, Alexander-Arnold, it's a fine run and he's happy to keep going. Oxlade-Chamberlain. He's in, surely.
Look, with time running out, they have to get the ball in the penalty box, and if it means a long punt, then so be it. They've got to give themselves a chance.
Going through. Well read, he sorted that out. And that's that. What a game. End to end, it flew by, and in the end, it all came down to just the odd goal.
Well, this game looked to have 0-0 written all over it, but credit to them, they upped their game in the end, and I thought they got what they deserved.
Well, that's it for tonight's match, so it just remains for me to thank Jim Beglin alongside me, and to wish you all a very good evening.